Good evening, good afternoon, and good morning. I'm Frizzmill, and today we're playing actually some Cult of the Lamb, because, yeah, I saw like last month they were actually releasing a new update later on this year, and, you know, I've seen other people play it and stuff like that, and I kind of wanted to go back and replay it again, because I had like a small save on here, but we're going to start with a new save and just like play catch up and see what we can do. I have missed this game. I like playing it when I first started off with it. So it's gonna be kind of like, it's gonna be nice to come back to it and go through all the usual stuff. Making me walk all the way here. Guys, this is not really how you do a sacrifice. You don't make me walk, it's... you know, this is kind of optional, right? I don't have to walk all the way up here. I guess I gotta kneel. And it'll be the end. No! Man, that was quick. Kinda weird, even though I'm in death, I'm still bound, you know? Much disappointment. The one who waits. So come closer, fear not. Though you are already dead, I still have need of you. I wonder, should I start doing like voices and stuff for all this stuff? Like, those foolish bishops thought they could keep you from me in death, but instead they sent you straight to me. I will give you life again, but at a price. All I ask of you is to start a cult in my name. Do we have a deal? Yes or absolutely bloody lootly. Wise choice. Take the red crown from which I once wore. With it you shall command the loyalty of followers and strike fear into the hearts of our enemies. Return to the land of the living and start a cult in my name, and begin recruiting followers. Once you have done so, you will see me again. Now go. Don't know. Should I keep doing voices? Might be more interesting. Cult of the Lamb. I have returned! But yeah, I mean... Let's have a look at this. Audio, master music volume. Turn that down a little bit. Turn that down. Don't know. Music seems a little loud there for a second. Might be just me. But yeah, I kind of really liked this game when it first kind of came out, and I don't know. I just kind of wanted to play it again. And I still like how I've been wanting to play other things on this channel as well. It's like, Ratu!
Fear not, I am Ratu. I was once a chosen vessel like you. But those days are lost to the winds. I was sent to guide you. We are deep in the lands of the old faith, and in grave danger.
My instructions are to lead you to safety. Continue through the woods. Escape the head. I will be close by. Good old Ratu. Chest. Money. Okay, get a coin. Currency used for all manner of things. How delightful. Yeah, I don't know how my voices are, but, you know, I enjoy doing stupid stuff like that. Something random. And I can either go up or to the left. Or, no, to the right. Left and right. Can't tell the difference. But yeah, I've been keeping myself busy for quite a while. And I've got other stuff I need to do currently at the moment, which I'm taking a small break from doing this. I kind of, you know, the madness is kind of set in, which is also why I'm probably doing some fun voices, because I do it to kind of relax and placate the insanity. So, you know, in that case, why not start a game about making a cult? You know? Sounds like the perfect game to be playing. We have nearly reached safety. But look ahead. A poor soul about to be sacrificed. Rescue them. And I would have no choice but to join your new cult.
Oh, mighty bishops of the old faith. We ask of you to accept the sacrifice of this wretched soul.
Sorry, that was such a stupid one. I loved it.
Hey, who interrupts our ritual? Trespassers on second ground.
I'm going to get done over for doing silly voices, I know. But it's still absolutely hilarious, these stupid ones. We shall rescue you, young one. Into the void you go. Ratu! We have safely... Oh, wait. We have reached safely. You have done well. The red crown will allow you to use those markings on the ground to transport yourself great distances. It'll take you to the temple as... fallen to ruin. There you'll be able to begin your new cult. I will meet you there. Thank you, Ratu. I appreciate it. Ratu's voice is one of those ones where I'm kind of like, I don't know how to kind of pull that off in the way I want to. It's probably going to do some iterations before I actually come up with a decent one. Maybe. Or maybe I'll just do it randomly every time. Please select difficulty. We'll go medium. Ratu! This hollow ground, which was once mine, is now yours. This crumbling ruin, this site of your new cult. You have much to do in the beginning to indoctrinating followers. Followers can gather resources, don't you? Yeah, okay, thank you very much. I'm sorry, Ratu. Unfortunately, I think you may have a weird voice at the end of all this.
Convert me to your cult. I will follow your teachings faithfully.
It's John. Is it Juno? Juno! We can choose his form and everything else and randomize him, whatever, but we're going to stick with whatever we get. So, I lose 10 faith for recruiting him. He levels up easy and he gains donation faster. That actually is absolutely fine. And you're going to go mine wood for me. Thank you. By your hand, cuts. Yeah, we get battle followers, get to cook meals, usual stuff like that. Cool. But I need to, like, mine stuff, collect stuff, do all sorts of other stuff. Which we'll do all this now, just so we can have all the resources. Like, the main thing at the point, like, for this first little bit, which I think is just going to do, like, the tutorial, do maybe, like, one run. And basically go from there. least that's what I want to do. Let's help our follower out, you know. There we go. So now I should be able to build what we need to build. So let's go do that. And a cooking station. Where do we want to put that now? Don't know, I always like the cooking stations to be fairly close by to most of the things, I guess. We'll go there. I built it myself. So yeah, just explaining like what we need to do to make sure we have devotion, all that sort of stuff, which we can now cook a meal, which I guess we'll do. Cook. And usual cooking minigame. There we go, you get to have food. Now we must build a shrine. Thank you, Ratu. I think, Ratu, your voice is gone. You talk way too much for me to keep a stable voice for you. But what I need now is gold, isn't it? Yeah. So I can build, like, faith buildings, usual stuff like that, and so on and so forth. So, let's go and do a first run, shall we? You can open this door by using our follower to pray. Is it pray to the hat? Ooh, there's a spider there, behind the scenes. But yeah, this is kind of like the whole bit I like about Cult of the Lamb. Because it's this idea of like building management along with like runs to gain resources and develops like sort of almost like a society, although you're just a giant cult. We'll equip the sword. Let's move on. And I do like the sort of clunkiness of the combat. Although I gotta get used to it again though. How can this be? You have put the blade lamb as all your kind were. And yet you stand before me unrepentant. The crown, his power. Could it be? But I am no longer still. Turn tail and run. Oh, I'm sorry. I am stronger still. Turn tail and run, little lamb. Don't know. Should we go with that? Or maybe we should go like a bit more kind of, little lamb. No. I don't know. I'd have to focus on doing silly voices and stuff like that. You know. Let the madness take over, as it were. Now, what I need to make sure I do is go around and cut stuff up so I have, like, all the resources I can get. Oh. Yeah, I really need to focus on, like, on what I'm doing, because I'm taking way too many hits already. It's been ages since I played this game, and I forgot how, like, the difference between the movement and stuff like that is way too, because I'm so used to being able to, like, just, like, tank through stuff, and remembering the animations is kind of hard. Ah, free heart. I like that. Let us continue. Ooh, chest. Yeah, we'll harvest bonus resources. Nice. Add that to the chest. Although, I still want to go to the other room that I haven't gone to yet. So explore everything. But yeah, I had a bit of a nice weekend. With, been busy sorting out all the other stuff and going to there. Praise the Lamb, conduit of great power, promised liberator of the one of the ways. So the card, show me once many lifetimes ago. What has it yet to be? I have always drawn your cards, Lamb, and yet, this is the first. Take these cards and I will draw another each time we meet. When drawn by me, they will grant you power. Power! Ooh. Free heart or just damages everything on screen with disease heart. Ah, disease heart. They're both the same. Thank you very much. So those are the cards now that can be drawn whenever I go and see him. And we'll unlock new ones going all the way through. Thank you. I just like how the lamb runs on like the animations. I think it's like absolutely adorable in the way that it's kind of meant to be as part of the satire. Ooh, we need some food here. Pick the berries. So yeah, normally this is kind of how like the game operates. It's like you have like a almost like a combat room. Then you'll normally have like some sort of event room, and then a combat room, then like an event room and a boss, and like they kind of alternate between all that sort of stuff. From what I remember correctly, and it depending on like how far you go in, the longer that will go on, the more rotations they'll do, and they'll go through levels and so on and so forth. Each one getting some like new upgrades or stuff like that, or and basically it's like rinse and repeat. Ah, another heart. Thank you. My newbiness is showing on this game still. I will say there's probably weapons I prefer compared to other ones as well, so as we go on we'll probably end up doing like some silly stuff. Between that I'm a resource hoarder, so I like doing a lot. Cool, Nick. Let's draw our tarot card. Receive double the health when healing, overall weapon damage increased. I'll take the increase in weapon damage. I like how, this is one thing about this game I probably would say is kind of nice, is hazards and traps are very noticeable when they're active, because they mark them with X's on the ground, which I think is an absolute genius part of the game. Should we change his voice a little bit? Maybe go something else. You have come far. Nah. What should we go with? It's not like, you have come far, little lamb. My followers will do anything for me. Can you say the same of yours? Asmodeus. I gotta do this. I gotta do this one's really stupid, don't I?
I give myself to the cause of my leader!
Blur the old great ones. Destroy the Red Crown.
Just the cry is what makes it kind of, for me, the whole point of why I gotta do it that way. Any charges? New charge. Charge. Charging.
Asmodeus, you are mine. Please spare me.
There we go. We shall take ourselves a member of the cult. I could go seeds. I could go wood and resource and stuff, but actually, we'll go lumber. I think like wood and resources, getting those early on, they're going to be a lot more important. We've got a lot more gold now as well. And this is kind of like the main mechanic which causes the replayability, like the replaying of the same level for a bit, is the fact that, like, you kind of go like defeat the mini leaders to then face the big boss at the end, which is kind of cool. The heretics defeated. Cleanse unbelievers. No damage from boss. Ooh, cool. I forgot that was even a mechanic. So I get, yeah, on the new items. And then we return to a little special safe haven. It's like, I am relieved you to see you have made it safely. You have not returned alone. You have convinced more to join our faithful flock. Let us indoctrinate and convert. Please spare me! You will randomize the name straight away. We'll randomize him as well, even though he was someone from a follower. And the trace you got is lose 5 faith when another follower dies, when another follower is sacrificed. Those are terrible, but yeah. There are terrible traits, but I guess we'll accept him. You are now known as the monkey. And the other one's getting wood, so you go mine rocks. So yeah, we can build a shrine, which will do that. I can't move the shrine anywhere else, it has to go in the center. Now my followers help me build. There we go. That guy's like, where the hell did I come from? Jano and Juno, we have both of those people. He's a sloth, so he hates doing his work. He's harder to level up. But he heals faster when sick. Fine, you lazy follower. You may be the one the first one to sacrifice, and I guess you're worshipping for now. So yeah, then game worship, and then we can upgrade stuff to go through. And that is kind of the repeat of the plan that we'll end up doing with this. Might as well speak. Work, worship, go do that for me, please. Go worship me. I will finish off your tree cutting. What we'll do is we'll get the last little bit of the devotion levels done, so at least we can unlock like the first thing, and then we'll probably leave the video for there and like leave it for like one run. And I'm gonna still kind of decide on what the best way to kind of do this entire area and stuff will be, is if I want to set it up so the fact that I kind of like have a time limit and I can do as many runs within that time limit, or we focus on like doing a bit of housekeeping and stuff like that, and then we go and do a run, or we do a run and do the housekeeping afterwards, which is kind of like the main thing. It's kind of like a debate between them all, because at the moment time is not ticking over in this place, so it's a good idea to kind of clean the area out now while I have the chance. And they start gaining that devotion for me. But while they do that, I'm just kind of collecting loads of resources. So you can receive 12. Divine inspiration is unlocked. And we just want to get one more. So we can unlock the sample. And the real question is how should I do this entire there we can unlock another one now. And we'll unlock the beds, I guess. So they can sleep. Now we'll build 3 beds, enough for the followers, and then we'll continue on from there. don't have enough stone. Interesting. So I guess I'll do that. Get enough stone so we can have, like, enough beds for everyone. I might be looking at the wrong place, so I've got to build a temple, that's why. But yeah, and then we'll have to decide kind of like how we want this cult to go as well, because there's going to be like the doctrines and stuff that we've got to decide on which way we want our cult to go. And judging from the traits of the followers I'm getting at the moment, we might be an evil cult. But yeah, I mean, if anyone's watching this stuff, let me know and we could decide that together. My temple. I always like putting it around here. As it goes kind of right in front of where people kind of enter. Let's build it. My place of worship is ready. Yes, thank you, Ratu. Our temple is going to be great, and we can generate faith. Oh, yeah, we're going to make sure we keep an eye on all that stuff. So now we have our faith meter. Ooh. Let's build some beds. Where should we put the beds and stuff? Do we put them at the top there? I'll put them all the way down here. One there. Telling me I don't have enough wood to build another bed. That's terrible. Oh yeah. Is it? No, it's the gold. Okay, I don't have enough gold. Collect all that while they're doing that. Create our sermon. And we get three straight away, yeah, because we've got three followers. Strength of the flock, so 3/8 of our followers can get stronger, before sermons, draw power from them, and then basically, yeah, do all that. So now I can basically hearts of faith also, I apparently gain half heart. And we can make myself stronger by going through and actually having more people to believe in me. Sermon of follow me or die. A natural leader. And we create documents, and then we need to get the old fragments to create doctrines. So cool. So yeah, now I've got to return to those old lands, as they were. You go chop trees. You get stone. And you can keep praying. There we go. So yeah, I mean, that's kind of the first kind of one I'll do of Cult of the Lamb. We'll probably do more as well going forward. We'll see how everything goes and the timers now start ticking down. So again, do enjoy these videos. Do leave a like, subscribe to see more, and I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.